my grandmother, my father's mother. Her name is Anusuya. Absolute integrity. The last day she died, she went to temple without missing her routine. Understand, going to temple from home, coming back, she cooked on her own. She lives on Swayambhaga. You see, in Indian tradition, the widow, after husband passes away, women live a very austere life. I have seen. She is the ideal widow. My father's father passed away even before my father's marriage. She is a young widow. I think maybe my grandmother became widow before even 30. Before she was 30, she became widow. The absolute ideal Hindu chaste widow's life I have seen in her. How traditional Hindu widows live, dedicating their whole life to spirituality and enlightenment. I have seen her living that life all by herself. She brought up all the three kids. Of course, it's a joint family. Means like a whole family supports. She had an elder brother whose daughter is my mother. And another one, brother. All three lived as a joint family. Practical joint family. But the way she completed her responsibilities, extreme integrity. Inside family, it is not that there will not be any problems or confusions or fights. My mother used to be terrorized by my grandmother. But nothing touched her spiritual integrity and life. Neither her religious practices, nor her spiritual practices, nor her spiritual activities. She lived absolute devoted, a Hindu sannyasini life, a devoted sannyasini or Rudraganya. How she will live? My grandmother lived that life. I should actually say, apart from managing her life and her kids, she will go every day, spend time with Mata Vibhudanandapuri Kuppammal. Not only she will go to street, shop to shop, collect small, small donations, do social service activities like Annadan. She will be so highly integrated to that money. She will not even bring that money to the home. She will keep in the Kuppammal's house itself. All activity will be done there itself. And all money will be spent. Accounts will be properly maintained. And all the donors will receive the prasadam. Extremely integrated. If I can create this kind of a extremely integrated people, nobody can push her. She's an elderly lady. She can one day rest without going to Thiruvannamalai temple, Arunachaleshwara temple. No. Never she will miss going to the temple and doing all her rituals. Not only that, she had her own managing system. How she will manage the temple officials and workers, staff. All the low-level staff, she will tip them. Through that, she will have a complete eye on the temple administration and make sure nobody cheats. If somebody cheats or misses the integrity, it's not that she will fire or scream or shout. She will very friendly way talk to his wife or his brother, through whom he should be advised or educated. She had her own network. She had her own network of friends, family, through whom she will reach out to that person and say, "Hey, Annamalai yaar paavanda, venanda. Paaru, kovil maattukku avathikkira varalennu solranga paaru. Adhellam sariya panittaadanda oor nalla irukum, odambu nalla irukum, pulla kuttinga nalla irukum." Means she will send the message to them, do not disturb the temple services. Only if all the temple services happens properly, the village will be flourishing and the children will be happy. The way she sends the message, it is too strategic. She will not straight away involve. I learned the strategical way of making people integrated from her only. She will not make people angry. She will not directly confront them. She will remind to them through right persons. She is literally right hand of Kuppammal. That is why the Kuppammal had a small organization. I should not say small. It's a maybe volume wise small, but the effort Kuppammal put her whole life. That organization is called Abhidhagusambal Tirupugal Sabai. It's fundamentally to promote the Shakta tradition and Arunagirinathar's Tirupugal on Subramanya Swami. You can see my grandmother and Kuppammal both. It's on exactly on that same Paramashiva Parai on which I became enlightened, on that same Shila. Only three people sat on that Paramashiva Parai. One is Kuppammal, my guru Vibhudanandapuri, and my grandmother Anusuya Ammal, and me. Only three have sat ever on that Paramashiva Parai. That Kuppammal's organization, she was president, and my grandmother Anusuya Ammal was vice president. Very extremely organized.